Most network security is based around permitting or denying something. Access control lists are an excellent example of this. Access control lists, or ACLs as they are commonly known, allow you to permit and deny traffic transmitted into or out of network interfaces based on a range of criteria. ACLs operate at wire speed with no impact on data throughput, which makes them ideal for use with high-speed ports. In HiOS, we've divided ACLs into two categories called basic and advanced. Don't be fooled by the names. Basic has limited configuration options, but these options are extremely powerful. You can decide to permit or deny communication based on IP addresses or protocols. For example, device A cannot communicate with device B, or device A cannot communicate with this group of devices, or device A can communicate with device B, but only to send events. As you can see, even with only a few decision criteria, you can build up very flexible rules. For beginners to the deployment of ACLs, these building blocks are a great way to become familiar with the concept. Once you become familiar with the concept of ACLs, it's time to consider how your network could benefit from the more advanced options. A video is not the right medium to discuss every possible option. There are just too many. But it's interesting to be aware of some commonly used configurations. You can permit or deny traffic based on its priority, the flags set in the headers, or whether the data has been fragmented into multiple packets. This would drop potentially malicious traffic. You can assign priority to incoming traffic. Great if your legacy devices cannot do this for themselves. Not all networks are in use 24 hours a day, so you can decide to apply the rules only at certain times. You can mirror the traffic to another port for monitoring and analysis. You can even force specific traffic to a defined port regardless of its intended destination. So far, we've looked at access control lists for TCP/IP traffic. But on OT networks, you will often find industrial protocols, and these protocols may not be based on TCP/IP. No problem. HiOS offers ACLs at Ethernet level. An Ethernet frame is much less complex than a TCP/IP packet, so there are fewer fields which can be used for filtering. This makes it simpler to create MAC-level ACLs. Basic ACLs support filtering on MAC addresses. Advanced ACLs support filtering on VLANs, traffic type, time of day, and other criteria. If you are familiar with firewalls, then you will recognize that firewall rules and access control lists have a lot in common. For example, filtering on addresses or protocols. So, what are the differences between firewalls and switches supporting ACLs? This is not a black and white topic, and there are many opinions. Let's examine some basics. Firewalls offer a functionality called stateful inspection. Put simply, stateful inspection will only allow data into your network if the data was requested from inside your network. Your home router with firewall probably works like this. It's a great function for use between networks. ACLs generally offer more filtering options, so they work better inside a network. Unlike firewall rules, ACLs are performed in hardware, so they operate at full speed and have no impact on your network performance.